put all our data. We lose control on it. Can you afford that? If your other industry player is going to use the economies of scale that the cloud provides with reasonable security that is there, he is going to bring down his input cost and create the efficiency in the market, you will not be able to compete. The minute you will not be able to compete, you will be routed out of the business. Your existence is going to be in the question, right? So Jackwell said, the outside change, the rate at which our outside world is changing, if you don't change, you would be outdated. Because of that, digital transformation is very, very important. So now modern gurus have started. What are the building blocks of digital transformation? Business model, customer experience, operational process, digital capabilities. When we say business model is actually, I have already explained to you, one of the gentlemen said that taking the business from offline to online. Sorry. Okay, some Alex further explain. I think this is going wrong somewhere. Sorry. My, is it going bad fast? Hold a sec, somewhere it is going bad. My slides are. Okay. Now when we talk about customer experience, customer understanding, operational process and business model. These are the three building blocks where one of the biggest consulting firm has, you know, built around. In this framework, if you look at it, what it is talking about is, for example, I'll tell you, earlier, if Air India was there, you got to go through the travel agent, book the ticket, right? And then nothing will happen. Maybe 2 days, flight was delayed, nobody will tell you what it is, right? Today, if you look at it, because of the digital platforms available, the industry is competing. If Air India is not able to engage the customer on the Facebook, engage the customer on the Twitter, engage the customer on every touch point where the customer is meeting on the digital world, Air India is today need to be bailed out. This is exactly what happened with the Air India. So when we talk about customer experience part, every time customer is asking a different and a new experience, it is going to go and exponentially grow. As a digital transformation guys, if you are not able to do that, then you have a trouble in hand. That is what actually happened with the AI. That is where the customer experience part. Then if you look at operational processes, this entire digital transformation cannot happen if somebody sitting in the enterprise and organization or a campus like this and tells that I am not going to allow my people to connect to the Facebook. I am not going to allow my entire communication channel through the Twitter because it is going to cause a risk in the confidentiality, integrity and of the information part. Right? If you do that, what is going to happen? If your operational processes which have been conditioned on a traditional mode of, you know, transaction or a way, you have to change. Those operations need to be changed. Once you, those processes are got changed, then you will have. There is a company that I see, it's a very big enterprise in India, which has almost 10,000 employees. It says that my internet policy says between 9 o'clock of the office hour to the 6 o'clock of the office hour, I will allow 9 websites in the globe. Rest all is blocked. Right? Who said great? Okay. Now, I don't believe in such kind of restriction is actually. I am one of the fascinate, you know, staunch supporter of net neutrality and also the freedom of internet, right? So when you talk about these kind of restrictions, if your entire workforce is not able to touch the touch points of the customers with this kind of block in your operational policies, you are going to get stuck. Now at the same time, extremely you get opened up, you are calling the red carpet welcome to the hackers. There has to be a fine balance that need to be made here. What is the fine balance? Do I know the fine balance formula right now here? I can give it to everybody? No. Every industry, every organization, every platform is unique and separate as human beings in this world. You will have to find your own balance, learning from the broad experiences that people like us have, right? So that is where, in most of these kind of forums, I keep, you know, getting questions like, sir, you are seeing this much of GAN to us, give us one formula, okay? If I can have that one formula, I will not be available to speak here also, right? That is the kind of time constraints that I would have. So there is no magic wand. Don't expect those kind of magic wands. Now, these are the business model changing from offline to online. That is what we spoke about. So one of the business transformation mode part, somebody said is, now I was told that, you know, there is a grand veteran on masala industry. He said to his next generation of people, guys, if you don't go and engage your customers online to sell masalas, you are surely is going to go out. Because there is a digital disruption that is going to come up. No more masalas are going to be bought, seeing the virtual reality of that, you know, the only the mind part of it. Now there is a disruption is happening where people are able to, when they are seeing the ads on the TV, they will be able to even sense through the nose what is the kind of flavor this masala has. And the experiments are going on, and this reality is going to be pretty true. Okay? So that is going to be possible in another, by 2020, already that veteran in that industry, everybody sees him on the TV, he told his next generation X that, guys, if you don't brace it up now, better you would shut down in 2020. So that is where offline to online in digital transformation part. So operational processes, you have to have robust mechanism to get the data on your fingertips. I was told, when I met in Andhra Pradesh Secretariat in Amravati, where there was a AP cyber security, you know, cyber policy document need to be, you know, debated and, you know, released. Then I was told somebody, he get a call saying that there is a drought that is going to happen in the Rayalaseema part of the Andhra Pradesh. How he got it? Then Naidu's secretary, the CM secretary, called up the IT secretary or, you know, other people, revenue guys, saying that this is going to happen in a week's time. You better be prepared. Then I asked them, how is it possible? They have a concept called real-time governance. The real-time governance is they use the Cisco's IoT technology. That's a digital transformation in the government they did. They know well in advance, with the accuracy of beyond 90%, that comes on the dashboard of the CM quickly in the real-time. And that dashboard goes to the revenue divisional secretaries as well, right? And they can plan it in real-time action in the real-time, right? When we talk about, if you have to do a digital transformation like this, you have to have the real-time data. That is what it is talking about, to improve the decision-making. Then if you look at it like that, not only the real-time data, then you will have to have the analysis part also. I had been part of one cyber policing, you know, crime analytics platform. I was amazed to see that a police officer, while going to the crime scene, gets three options in front of him, saying possible crime, possible gangs, the possible people are this. Your possible actions could be 1, 2, 3 before he reaches to this part of the crime, right? So your analyzing skills also on the go is very, very important. That is what the digital transformation is going to tell you when it comes to the operational processes, right? Now, this is a very classic example of customer experience. How L'Oreal has used the app Makeup Genius to increase its sales tremendously. It is a reality. Those who are very fashion conscious, those who are into the film and glamour industry, they know that, you know, this brand and how it has transformed from a traditional way of selling its product to this, right? Now, I'm going to come to the part of actual question. What is this CISO's role is going to be? I'm just introducing you to this fundamental concept of digital transformation. Any questions so far? Yes.
Huh.
digital transformation, see, this is a technique or a method of the holistic platform of digital transformation. If you are connecting your web to a cloud platform or a cloud analytics data or whatever it is, you are doing it to improve your customer experience so that you can get a real-time thing. So is it a part of digital transformation? Could be yes or no. Why? Because you are only connecting to your private stakeholder, one stakeholder, then it becomes your operational efficiency issue. You are not going larger. So the building block of a digital transformation, how securely you can improve process, product to deliver value and customer experience. This is what is the meaning, value and customer experience. I myself can tell you, earlier from New Delhi airport, if I have to go to my station, first is my experience is I will not get good driver, all rude drivers. They demand 3x of the money, what is the natural one. That was the bad customer experience. That experience has been, Uberization has actually completely changed, right? At my fingertip, right? I can choose the best driver, the cab driver, right? The second is at the best of the cost, the value, look at the value. Earlier from Palam airport, you know, to come to my SouthX house, it used to be some 800, 1000 rupees kind of thing. When Uber and Ola came, it reduced to 400, 500. So you delivered using these technologies, both the customer experience, that is getting it at my fingertips, and the value also. Earlier I put that much money, I get a bad experience. Today half of that money, I get a beautiful experience. That's the difference here, right? So, so little bit of MIT, what MIT talks about, I'm going to have plenty of slides on the security front also. I'm going to connect this entire story. Kali, how much time I have? Or am I taking more? So, MIT, mobilize, focus, frame, sustain. This is the MIT Solon Management Institute said. When in 2013 or 2012, they wanted this digital transformation to be fundamentally defined and put a kind of compass. What they are saying is mobilizing. Mobilizing in the sense, take everybody, the board, everyone in the entire enterprise and an entity, what is the need, how you can go, and tell them the compelling reasons why you need to be on digital transformation path. DX path is must. In the human life also, I said we do a lot of transformational journeys. When we are youngsters, we are very happy on the campus, chatting with the girls, boyfriends, girlfriends and all that stuff. That is the phase of the journey. Then we transform into another journey, right? That journey of, you know, a kind of maturity, sensibility, adulthood. Then we go into a kind of philosophical mode when we cross 40s and 50s, right? So in the similar way, if you look at it, mobilization in any organizational journey in terms of transforming the digitization, who would take this role? It could be entire stakeholders, business stakeholders, the organizational external stakeholders, possibly one of the company which I worked, they have given a beautiful idea to them, to that company, that saying, if I do not know, it was a garbage management company in Spain, if I do not know when your guy is going to come to collect garbage at my location, right, my cost stink management is going to increase. Then they have gone ahead, put sensors on stink management using the IoT, so that wherever the garbage is stinking, instead of following the linear route of picking it up, that vehicle goes by the sensor data, whichever is stinking first, it will go and pick it up, right? Thereby, the cost of managing the garbage stinking has reduced to those customers, right? Likewise, there are companies whom customers will tell, why do you need to transform? So in the similar way, you need to focus, fund the transformation. Without finance, nothing moves, right? You have to have a compelling reason and tell to your, you know, organization, look, if you don't adopt this now with this much of money, this is what you are going to lose. This is what the opportunity that you are going to lose. And later on, you want to get into it, you will not get it. Final example of it is actually, I'll give one of the example. The Intel, the monarch of the semiconductor and computing world, when I had a chat with them, they said that we lost the mobile battle. Mobile semiconductor battle. Why? We have not transformed. We have not envisioned saying that ARM can take over us, right? Qualcomm can take over us. Today, in your phone, there is no Intel inside. Are you with me? So this is the transformation. The biggest visionaries, Harvard graduates, the Wharton gurus, when they have to miss, they will miss the bus. Right? And the same bus was missed again by the Microsoft Steve Ballmer, who believed cloud is not going to sustain. Then that thought process of Steve put Microsoft almost 5 years behind and allowed a retailing company like Amazon to challenge every IT monarch in the web that, you know, I can do the cloud better than you, right? Today it holds 80% of the cloud consumption based market, right? So then it says that framing, where to start? When the run is already started, you are actually catching it up, you should know where to pick it up so that you don't get exhausted, sap your energy, get lost into the system, into the entire this transformational journey. That is what the MIT says. Then it says that not only this, once you get there, you need to sustain. All the hard work you do to become a number one hero in the Bollywood and make simple mistake, get out of the entire industry. So that is not going to be the story. You have to sustain also that digital transformation. You saw on the other side of the, you know, the photo where transformation was happening, but he got burnt his, this McKinsey came up. This guy said, okay, why should I be behind when everybody is defining the DX framework? He says, in a normal commercial language, if you look at McKinsey kind of guys talks on the dollar front, they talk about the automation, innovation, connectivity, decision making. Their thought of the framework. They say that anything that you do, automate. If you are doing a process now of finding out the best IQ students in this BITS Pilani by going through your Excel sheet, they said that is not the way. Use AI, use Watson, right? Throw them random IQ test based on the Mensa, right? And let the Watson tell you which are the best guys. That is what the automation part, right? So in case of automation, they are saying that maturity needs to be brought. Once you get automation, probably you are the guy who can, you know, take the DX journey well. That's what the McKinsey is selling you. And the rest of the part is innovation is already we spoke about. This is the just part of the how DX frameworks are working. Now, what are the critical fundamental principles behind the DX, which is well accepted in the industry today, is simplification. When we said simplification, earlier also I said simplification. Today we have huge amount of data and digital red tapeism is increasing like anything. Today I was part of e-passport seva. I never thought that this can happen to me actually. That is where I said digital red tapeism. If anybody is there from e-passport, please excuse me. Right? Security, I was part of it with the TCS. Right? When what happened is, I saw that, you know, when this entire manual effort of booking appointment for going to the passport office and all will get completely changed, when this entire e-passport seva comes in, all of a sudden after this entire program went up 2 years down the line, when I go in Hyderabad, the broker was telling me, if you want faster appointment tomorrow only, you got to bribe me. I said, how? Sir, for that how only you are paying me? Why should I tell you? I gave him 1,000 rupees, he got me the appointment. So this is something I'll tell you is a digital red tapeism here. When the entire power, which was there and traditionally on the paper, used to be controlled by the Babus earlier, right? Which was hard to get into it, there was a red tapeism, what we call as a traditional red tapeism, right? Now it is getting into a digital red tapeism. So when you try to do a simplification also, you have to ensure that simplification is true simplification. When you want it, you need to get it. So not the one that I spoke right now. We did the automation. We said that we simplified the process. You don't need to go physically there to get an appointment, but still it is not the true simplification. So when you talk about DX fundamental principle, it lays the biggest foundation. If you are in the false sense of simplification, please change that. Your simplification test is against the digital red tapeism. If your simplification is not standing against the digital red tapeism, you are not, you still not simplified. Second is automation. We spoke about the automation part. Automation part, so many people have asked me. Automation is what? Does it require human intervention? If it requires human intervention, do we call it as an automation? The answer is yes or no. Why? Because automation can give rise to safety issues. Automation beyond a point can give rise to the safety issues and security issues. What does it mean? For example, in an enterprise, if you look at it, you are getting some attack information because you have security analytics platform in your organization, right? If you think that, how do you ensure that once, whenever a virus detected event comes to your security analytics platform, do you need to take an automated decision that, you know, shut down the entire network? If what happens if it is a ISRO network, if it is a NASA network, the entire rocket launching programs will come down on their own, right? Multi-billion dollar loss is going to happen. So the automation means till a point where confidence level can be had beyond reasonable doubt, automation can allow to happen on its own without human intervention. Automation beyond that level needs the human intelligence into it, right? If somebody tells me here AI and ML is going to completely change the story, ladies and gentlemen, spend 2.5 decades on security analytics, I can tell you it is not going to do that. It's again, AI and ML is dependent from here only. How you train it, how what you tell it is going to do it. So then security aspects, continuous innovation. Security aspect, that is what I'm going to tell you in the next few slides. Those aspects you cannot forget. You cannot take them for granted, right? Always in every fora, I keep telling, it is much better to have no security rather than having false sense of security. Most of the organization or government departments I consult, they heavily rely on false sense of security. In one of the ministry, that is Interior Ministry in Delhi, one time I went ahead with my own hands, I did a POC to find out in Interim Ministry what is happening on threats front. I am surprised to see when I did a packet capture, there are director, deputy director level people in that organization was charting, sending so much of sensitive information via Skype. And each one of them I have captured for a period of 25 days. I got to destroy that captured machine. And so unaware of the fact that how much danger that they are doing it to the nation, to themselves as well. So that is the level of, you know, kind of awareness that they have. So whenever we talk about continuous, anything that you do, you will have to have continuous vigil on it. Otherwise, the DX can be a fatal transformation or journey for you also. Right. Now, so as usual, any new transformation happens, any new journey happens, whether a young boy is trying to marry, or a middleman is trying to buy a home, right? Or something else big he wanted to do, he, she, any organization, either it is a human entity, non-human entity, will always be a crossroad. Then you, a kind of, you know, matrix comes out, wherein you will have this kind of transformational intensity and digital intensity. Management intensity is, there is a CEO who is very fancy, or there is a AP CEO, AP CM, like he runs the entire AP as a CEO, right? He has very much, you know, enthusiasm in terms of using entire cloud, entire transformational technologies and everything. So that is the intensity of the management part. And this digital is the technical part of the story, right? How you are actually adapting those digital platforms to really come to the place where you want to, right, in the transformation. Where in the last, digirati is the rachi, where you feel the level of maturity, sensibility with security you completed, or you are on the path of right journey. I never say DX journey is a complete journey. Today what you are seeing is in 2020, you may not see. In 2020, you never have a laptop. This kind of laptop will not be available. I think if the journey is very faster, it will go in 2019 as well. So laptops are going to go. So the beginners, then you have conservatives, the people who says we don't because of security reasons, or other reasons. And the fashionist guys, they are false sense of guys. They say that we transformed ourselves into DX, but they never transformed. This is the matrix. What are the challenges? This slide tells you that it's a bitter reality. Every human who was born should die, will die. That's the bitter reality. Okay, that's the reality. I think I got a call. I have to finish fast. I don't have time. Okay, no matter whatever it is being said, anything that you connect the minute to the network, it has the potential to get hacked. No doubt about it. And the security challenges comes from this slide also. This says that on the left hand side, if you look at it, there are countries where the attacks are coming up. We see India from the bottom four, and where the attacks are taking place, India is not there. In any DX transformation, this slide tells you we are lying ourselves, because we don't have any statutory, okay, disclosure norms here that if you get hit, you have to tell, right? That is not there. Because of that, I am not, you know, you are not visible. But if that was there, we should have crossed the United States, or after United States, we should have been there. So this one slide tells you that DX transformation journey, security flaws. Ever demanding new customer experiences. Sir, my story is over. Now you are telling me on Facebook, you are giving me on Twitter messages, you are giving me WhatsApp messages. Till the time I sit in my Air India thing, this is over for me. I need new experience. So new experience puts enormous pressure on the DX transformation again, and then subsequent security challenges on it. New business models. You never thought of it. There is a new model has come up, which forces you to shut down four factories and go and, you know, open new new areas of addressing that business model. Again, if you look at it, this is the data, 2016. The loss in million US dollars is 1736 million in case of, as of August data, if you can look at it. Why I am showing this data is, all gurus like us standing as a cyber security experts in the last 20 years, 30 years, why you have failed to stop this? So much of knowledge is there, so much of experience is there, still why this slide is telling 2016 this much of money has been lost? That tells you, no matter what you do, absolute security is not in your hands. It's only the Almighty God can give you. So we cannot fear with this kind of statistics. We have to move with the journey. Because you say that if I do a air travel accident, I am going to die. There is no guarantee that when you are talking, you know, walking on a campus, you may not die. Okay? This stat tells you two facts. One fact is, there is a hard reality that no matter what you do, you have to be vigilant. You can't sleep. You can't be, you know, taken for granted. So this is what the slide is telling. Now, rate of change. In the very beginning, I said, the biggest challenge for the DX is that you woke up, you can't run fast, you can't change fast, then you are gone. You made mistakes of security, because the pressure come on you, you allow the application to get connected to the Facebook, get a smack analysis on it, and I am there on the Facebook, I came, come in, third party risk happens, you are gone. 24/7 digital life, still at least we are away from smartphone talking to our kids. Nowadays I see that my kiddie, he says that, Papa, leave me alone, I am playing, you know, Barbie girl or some crossword, I will talk to you later. That later will never happen. She sleeps, I go to office, I will come back. So I am competing with my kid to get her attention, because this digital life has snatched away the traditional bonding as well, right? Now, is it good or bad? Debatable issue, right? But I am of the opinion, I have not been able to compete with the digital life, what my kid has. It is my failure, it is not the kid's failure. That is again one more risk for the DX journey. Fraud detection complexity. The minute you try conquer one fraud mechanism, you get into the another fraud. You cannot imagine that fraud is there, the fraud happens. I give you an example. I request them, still allow me 5 minutes more. There was a doctor in Hyderabad, trusted a driver for 10 years. He used to give him a telephone bill to pay in traditional way, an Aadhaar photocopy. He knows his the user ID, banking user ID. One fine day, his mood has changed. After all, he's a human being. Picked up that Aadhaar card, forged the signature, went to a Airtel showroom.